Any other questions?
Neha ji, on your left.
Sir, cricket is always going to be a very integral part of my life. I don't think I can ever quit that. I love the sport and it's given me a livelihood and I'll always value that. So I'll keep cricket for sure.
And now you're getting to do the best of both. You get to play it. You play a cricketer in a forthcoming film.
Neha ji,
yeah?
Season 3.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, huh? Next question.
Okay, Neha ji, season 3 ka video hame dekhne ko mila, kafi entertaining and fun tha. To aapko nahi lagta ki ab time aa gaya ise TV pe aane ka, iska video aana chahiye kyunki audio humne dekha bahut hi interesting hai, video bhi aana chahiye?
Ji, bilkul, hum you know, kyunki hum co-produce karte hain show between Big Girl Productions, that's my production company, and Savan. Hamari ye baat cheet chali thi and we thought that at no point we wanted to become a hybrid show ki, you know, fir hum na idhar ke rahenge na udhar ke rahenge. We wanted to go, we want it to go video, but maybe in a year's time or maybe the year after. But right now, if I may say so myself, in all modesty, you know, the fact that we've got these millions of streams and we've been doing extremely well and we're almost number one player as far as an audio show is concerned, we'd like to stay on top in the category that we belong to and then move on to video when we can. Also, audio karne pe ek alag kism ki mystery jo hoti hai, jo guest ko lagta hai ki koi aaspaas nahi hai. Of course, you know, they get comfortable because
they're less conscious.
Sorry?
The guests are less conscious.
Yeah, they're less conscious and, you know, us tarah ke ek concept jo aaspaas hota hai. And, you know, I mean, Gaurav's here on my left and he produces and hosts a wonderful show called Breakfast with Champions. And he'll agree with me, the more comfortable and the less cameras that you have around, but his show is video and then he manages to do such a good job of it because unko lagta nahi hai ki wo actually baatcheet kar rahe hain, but bina kuch bole bhi wo kafi kuch bol jate hain. I mean,
yeah, the internet is the content that you make, especially when it's on the internet, when it's streaming, it has to evoke a sense of intimacy for the person who's viewing or the person who's listening. Because the internet is not like television. Television is consumed in India, family, like people consume it together. Everything on the internet is consumed individually. So they're either listening or they're watching like that on their phones. So it's got to be a little intimate. And that's why I like the show so much, because इन्होंने एक माहौल ऐसा बना दिया है कि आप जब सुन रहे हैं तो आपको लगता है कि बस ये दो हैं और मैं हूँ और हम तीनों के अलावा और कोई नहीं है यहाँ पे. So that they do, that we try to do on video, and they do really well on audio.
And Neha ji, dusra sawal ye hai ki dheron sari celebrity, dheron sari personality aapke show mein aati hai, and humne video bhi dekha, kafi entertaining and fun hota hai. Koi aisi personality jiska aapko bhi intezar hai ki aane ka, ki haan, ye aaye hamare show mein?
No, I'm a very big Shah Rukh Khan fan. Mm-hmm. And year after year, hamari kahin na kahin baat aise hum chhedte hain is baat ko, and Shah Rukh's always like, yeah, I'm going to come, and then kuch na kuch, it's a timing thing or something else. But yeah, it'll be great to be in conversation with him because I feel that, you know, he's amazing on film, on video, on any chat show. There's no topic that he can't talk on. And I've been in conversations with him many, many times in my life. And it's always been extremely interesting. And hopefully one day we'll capture that conversation and put it out on No Filter, Neha.
Soha and Sophie ko bhi dekhenge hum?
Bilkul. Soha and Sophie and Gaurav, sabko hum dekhenge turn by turn. But
aapko nazar nahi aa raha hum kitne enthusiastic lag rahe hain?
I mean, mere liye bahut badi baat hai that on such a special day like the launch, my friends are here with me and supporting me through this, and that's the most important thing.
Any more questions? Because I have.
Thank
I
you
have
very much, man. Yeah, question. So I planted the question with
you. You did. No,
thank you. Good
do
job.
Do you have a question? Anybody? I have one. Huh? Batai.
Big girl has another question.
Big girl has a question.
Big girl has a question.
Okay, I have one question. In fact, two questions, Neha.
Somebody has a question.
While they're figuring. Oh, you have a question?
Feel free to ask as many questions, guys. No problem.
Neha, is it easier for you to get the celebrities comfortable because you have already worked or you know most of them? So, do you think it's easier for you to get them to talk and to reveal stuff?
I mean, I'd have to say, yeah, most definitely, yes. The hard part is actually convincing them to come on the show. Because we get guests who we don't know, who I don't know really well, but we're all from the same fraternity, and they're nice enough to come on the show. And then they're like, karna kya? And they start with a little bit of hesitation, but after the chat is over, they're extremely comfortable. And like last year, I didn't know Sonakshi at all. And I just cold called her, and I was just like, Sonakshi, will you come on the show? And she was just like, yeah, most definitely. But after doing that show, we ended up becoming, you know, close and friendly, and now we chat a lot more. So I think that chemistry comes in because, you know, theek hai, industry ki hai, won't go that far. And as a producer, the first thing I say to them is, please speak your heart out, and in case you want me to edit anything at all, it'll go in the bin immediately. So protecting them is the most important thing for me.
Can I ask you quickly? Sorry. Have celebrities asked you to cut out things?
Yes, lots of times. And you'll be surprised. You basically think, okay, this one's going to be very strict and ye kuch bolenge. So, you know, sometimes, like I was, I've just finished shooting for Ela with Kajol, and her episode is going to be in the release week of Ela. And I'm very grateful to her that she's come on the show. And I was like, you know, most definitely because
You expected her to be very filtered.
I would, yeah. And then she just didn't ask for any cut. She didn't ask for any, like, sort of, you know, even a word was like, I was like, would you want me to edit anything? And she was like, absolutely not. She spoke her mind. She knew what she wanted. And she was very entertaining.
And she was fine with the bloopers, too.
Absolutely fine. And then there are other people who you think, who I can't name, who you think are going to be, just to protect them, who you think are going to be lots of fun, but they'll keep messaging and asking for edits. But as a producer, you have to protect your guests and then, you know, edit whatever they want.
I figured you'd be surprised by some.
There's a question. Over this side, yeah.
Yeah.
सबसे पहले तो शो की ढेर शुभकामनाएं आपको. आपसे जानना चाहूंगी, मी टू मोमेंट की लहर दौड़ रही है बॉलीवुड फ्रेटर्निटी में. पहले तनुश्री दत्ता, उसके बाद अब कंगना रनौत. आप क्या कुछ राय व्यक्त करना चाहेंगे इस पूरे मी टू मोमेंट के बारे में?
You know, as a woman, not just as an actor, it's something that when we started hearing about it and we started reading about it, it made me angry, it made me furious. And the fact that women are coming out and speaking about it is firstly, it should not happen. Secondly, it's very, very brave that they're coming out and speaking about it. And I feel that all of us, like sometimes I read articles and see, you know, that we're still questioning it. I think there's no need to question it. We have to believe them. They can't put themselves out there to such an extent. And then people are still saying that, oh, what if, what not? No, not at all. I mean, it's a big movement. It started and it's great. Now the real cleanup will happen. It is going to happen. It is happening as we speak. And it's important that something like this is happening in India as well. So I would love to go out there, support any woman who needs my help, anybody who's coming out and talking about it. And yeah, talking about it now also makes me angry. Yeah. So I'm going to stop.
I just want to add something. I think it's... Go. Sorry, I mein kehne lagi thi ki I think the worst thing that's happening is people are asking Tanushree why 10 years later. I think it's really sad that that's what we're focusing on, because in 10 years she did disappear. Wo apni prime mein nahi hai ki she's suddenly going to come back and become some A-list heroine by creating news and creating controversy. To be honest, having known Tanushree a little bit, I think she was on a show. Unse pucha gaya ki aap filmon se kyun gayab hui. Unhone saaf jawab de diya. और आजकल का एनवायरनमेंट ऐसा है कि वो बात बहुत बड़ी बन गई, व्हिच इज़ रियली ग्रेट, बिकॉज 10 इयर्स अगो, इवन इफ आई हैड ट्राइड टू ब्रिंग अप अ फ्यू इश्यूज एंड मेनी ऑफ अस हु मस्ट हैव फेस्ड थिंग्स, द एनवायरनमेंट वाज़ नॉट फ्रेंडली. गॉड फॉरबिड अगर आप थोड़े बहुत ग्लैमरस थे, यू वुड एंड अप गेटिंग द ब्लेम. एंड वी हैव सीन इट इन द पास्ट, इवन विद समबडी लाइक अ ममता कुलकर्णी, हु वाज़ एट द पीक ऑफ हर करियर, शी वॉज कंप्लीटली एलियनेटेड ओवरनाइट. That was the mahal before. Today, women are speaking and they're getting more support. Are we at the level of America? No, I don't think so. But I think we need to definitely create a more positive environment for women to start speaking, to start opening up. Aur agar hamare sawal aise honge ke 10 saal baad kyun, if that is the focus, I think that's a very negative focus. I think you need to encourage people to speak. And I think you also need to make those lines very clear. What is harassment? What is, you know, what is actually harassment, and that needs to be made very, very clear.
And just to add to what Sophie's saying, the 10 saal baad kyun 10 saal pehle, you know, even Farhan has mentioned, taken up with Anushree and said ki wo 10 saal pehle bhi ho raha tha. We've seen footage. Yeah. We've seen the fact that people were pushing her car. We've seen footage like that. So the fact that she's waking up 10 years later, that's not the point. She tried speaking even then.
Yeah, and she wasn't given the
chance. So let's not question that. Let's question the people who are in the line of fire. Let's question the men. Let's listen to the women a little more carefully. Let's not just turn a blind eye. Let's not turn a deaf ear to the situation and to what's happening. It's time we all wake up, guys.
Soha?
I think they've both spoken so eloquently. I don't want to repeat them. But I think that it's wonderful that women are speaking out. It's very difficult to sometimes be a woman in a country like India. They go through a lot on a daily basis. And certain things we've just accepted as this is the lot of a woman, to be harassed on a regular basis, whether you're on a train, whether you're at work, whether you're in the film industry, whether you're in a bank. You've just accepted it. You've been taught to brush it under the carpet. You've been taught that you'll be a difficult person to work with, and we've all moved on with our lives. It takes a lot of courage to stand up and say that I want to tell my story, and women need to be supported. Women need to be encouraged when they do that. So it's a wonderful thing that it's being spoken about, that it's being accepted. I don't know what consequences are going to take place, if any. I hope that there will be some consequences, because at the end of the day, that's what people want to see, a change. That's what this whole movement is about. So without saying anything else, I completely stand in support of any woman who wants to share her story.
Yeah. Yeah, hi, Neha. Hi. Congratulations.